So, my name is Cadet Ethan Mullen. I'm here to talk to you about entrepreneurship. However, I really don't know anything about entrepreneurship. So, I went out and I searched it and I tried to find out what it is. And I found it with my brother. And my brother is he's starting a small technical writing company in Austin, Texas. And he gave me an analogy in a short phone call that I think really makes things easier for the common person to break it down. Because for people like me, I have no idea what entrepreneurship. Like, I could probably find a definition, but when it comes to like what it truly is, I have no idea. So his analogy that he gave me is, it's like building a plane, right? Like building a jet engine, but it's already in the air, right? It's already flying. And it can go down at any minute, right? This is your project, this is your pride and joy. But you gotta keep it in the air. That's the entrepreneur's job, is to keep the plane in the air. So how do you do that, right? An entrepreneur keeps the plane in the air by changing parts and remaining adaptable, right? They have to continuously move and figure out what can they do with the resources they have to make the plane better. If they change the size and shape of the fuselage, will that make it more fuel efficient? If they change the pitch of the wings, will that create more thrust? Or will it create some downfall and put them in a spiral, right? So they have to keep adapting and keep changing. And they do this not for themselves. Do it for everybody that's already on the plane, right? They do it for the employees, the executives, the investors, the clients, and the families. The families involved, because you've got to put food on the table at the end of the day. So if they were to give up, if the entrepreneur were to walk away, well, then that plane's going down, right? And then at that point, everybody on the plane with it is going down too. So the entrepreneur needs to wake up every day positive attitude and just accept the fact that there's risk involved in these issues. Right? There's going to be risk involved. So, moving forward from that, at this point in the conversation, my brother made it real. He gave me a good life example, right? Because planes are cool, but I'm not an aviator guy. So, he said that he's building a house, right? And he's been designing this house for 3 years with all the engineering and design process in it with his fiance. And now it's time to pour the slab and build the frame. Beautiful, sent me a video of it. And then just this Monday, he got an email from the loan company, from the bank. The loan's canceled because it started construction before they had a full approval. Even though he already signed the loan and had approval, there was just some sort of law that they had broken somewhere. Now, he can point fingers and say, hey, to the inexperienced construction manager that he had, why did you start construction before we had full approval? Or you can turn around and point fingers and say to the loan officer, like, why did you say we could start if we couldn't actually start, right? But none of that's going to solve the problem that he has to get $62,000 to the loan by tomorrow, Friday, February 16th. So that's kind of a big deal, right? But we developed a plan on it. He took responsibility for it, and he's going to fix it, right? We talked about it last night. But that being said, at the end of the day, he just said to me, hey, my house is a B-52, and I'm standing here. So, with that being said, I think that's the kind of attitude you need to have as an entrepreneur, and I think that's all you can really do, is just kind of stay positive and keep moving forward, even in the face of adversity. That's all I got. Thank you.
Thank you.